You see, I am not there. I have been radiated into the astral level. Okay? Now, the truth is, I am not well, acquainted with this camera, and it turns off after 10 minutes. So I have to put it on again. So I don't know what I have already told you, but the biophotonic light is a combined action of all those cells of your body that are communicating with one another with this light, with this coherent laser light, biophotonic light. And so it well may be that all those mysterious stories we have heard have an element of truth. You talk about light body, the mental body, and the astral body, that the highest and finest level of coordinating the metabolism in all cells is this laser light. And so if you then take it in on the level of imagination, you visualize your bones and your inner organs, you look into the heart, the lungs, the ribs, the pelvis, whatever, especially those parts where you have a problem, then and clean it, visually clean it. And that is, I can help you definitely with my good knowledge of physiology and anatomy. So I've had this medical education in studies of physiotherapy, and it's naturally it's also my hobby to study it. If I want to clean it, I know what is inside me, and then you will have a complete workout, which is before, and then the mental workout at the end. You're so full of harmony, energy, and the surrounding power of nature that you will be what? No, you will not be immortal, that you will live for a long time. This is Oko, where I can help you as a philosopher of life to distinguish between the belief in immortality and the belief of, you know, regenerating the life force so that you live for a long time. In the old time in Greece and in all the times in old cultures, there was a belief in long lives, and later on, only after Plato and other idealistic, idealistic philosophers have created this concept of a perfect immortal idea, which is a kind of a projection of the concept of a human idea, of a concept, like if I say an arm as a word is not a real arm. You know, there are millions and millions of real arms, millions and millions of real people, but I can take theoretically in a medical book about an arm. So, and this concept arm seems to live independently of all those individual arms. And this has so fascinated obviously I've been studying, I have my master's in linguistics, okay, in German university, very deep, okay, Heidegger and so on. It has been so fascinating for those thinkers that they have said, well, this is true. There must be a realm in which forever these perfect ideas are, you know, stored, and if we get somehow into this realm, we shall be immortal. This idealistic philosophy, which, you know, in real terms, if you look at the philosophy of Nietzsche and of the present day, the top philosopher Peter Sloterdijk, they support more the idea that in the... Now we have become lecturing. This may be the part of the program after the meditation has been done and you are walking in the woods or on the sea alongside the sea on the higher mountains of the Alps, and you want to know about the real secrets of life, which are philosophical truths, not mysterious, but philosophical truths, because I see myself also as a philosophical life counselor. I have studied most of the modern philosophy, which is body-oriented, as I have been talking now about Peter Sloterdijk, a German philosopher who says the third millennium, the time we live now, has a specific quality in it as far as spirituality is concerned. You have to take your body with you if you enter a spiritual realm. This is the new thing. For the two and more millennia before, it has been always believed that you have to, you know, cut the body off. You have to free the spirit, free the mind, and travel into those bodiless, materialless realms. Realms without matter. And actually, if you know Nietzsche, and he would say this is a kind of expression of decadence, if you are ill and if you face extermination and there's war and suffering, naturally you believe in something which is better than that. And that is a realm where you cannot be harmed, you can be hurt, and you cannot die. Okay, so this is the idealistic realm. Now, this has been proved many times as false in human history. So, in practical terms, so now we believe, modern man believes in living for a long time, you know. And I have been working with old people very many times in old people's houses, senior houses. And I can tell you, I know a lot of people who are 100 years old. And if you live an active life for 100 years, I say you are happy and you have enough. Okay? You don't dream about forever, because it becomes, you know, it doesn't become boring. But, you know, it becomes, I guess, too regular, you know. But if you, you know, enjoy every day this beauty, this is so wonderful, so that you know, you will live for a long time. Also, přátelé, jak se máme teď tady, jak si chcete se učit anglicky, podíváme, jestli se nám to natáčí. Zase se trošku musím dát do pohybu. Tak to vidíte, že když zakončíte prostě tuhletu sekvenci potom tou meditací, jo, a vyčistíte si to tělo tím světlem, jo, a potom můžete prostě dostat náladu potom, když to se skončí a máme třeba nějakou snídaní, že jo, protože tohle všechno jede před snídaní, že jo. Ráno jsem si dal jenom banán a nějaký džus, jo. Mám sebou něco, kdyby mě chytl hlad, samozřejmě. Ale když potom máme chuť na rozhovor, jo, tak to se to všechno dovíte, jo. Protože já jsem studoval filozofii jako koníček teda, samozřejmě, ale studoval jsem hlavně, a mám na to papír, taky lingvistiku na německé univerzitě. Protože když diskutujeme o něčem, tak to se děje v jazyce, že? Tak bychom měli vidět, jaký jsou možný argumentace a co je prostě literární jazyk, co je vědecký jazyk, co je hypotéza, co je teorie a jak jsou takové ty možnosti argumentace. A já vám teda říkám, že právě moderní jazykověda i filozofie, psychologie, neurofyziologie a tak dále tendujou k tomu přesvědčení, že je opravdu možno žít dlouhou dobu, pokud děláme tu velmi pravidelnou prevenci a udržíme